crowd right into this game now. 7-4, 5-3. Wonderful skills by Sydney and close there. Garlick's handball a big winner. Kelly pushes forward. Taken by Grant. Grant chips to Lockett. He's got him. The moment has arrived. And it's come early.
Well, what will be the crowd reaction, Bruce, if he kicks it? Will they charge onto the ground?
Security everywhere behind the goals. See the yellow coats everywhere.
Are they ever? But they're not out in the wings.
First kicked 100 goals in 1987. Did it again in 91 and 92 for St Kilda. And then last year for Sydney, he'll join Dunstall and Hudson as the men to have kicked 100 goals on five occasions if he drills this through. A magic moment. Lockett from 35 metres out. He's got it.
Here they come. Look at it. Oh, they had no hope of stopping this, Bruce. No chance of stopping this crowd. Great performance by Lockett. Magnificent.
A magnificent achievement by Tony Lockett. But this gets dangerous.
Oh. See, the overview from here is astonishing. A lot of the Richmond players are in the centre square, just bundled up together. Sydney, by the way, are 8-4 to 5-4. 100 goals for the fifth year for Lockett. Magnificent achievement.
It is. It's got to be acknowledged as one of the all-time great efforts. And I think, let's not detract from that, but we just have to be careful here. There's kids on the ground. Anything could happen. What you have to weigh up, Bruce, in this situation is not take it away from the fans, but let them just appreciate that it can get a bit out of hand.
Tigers are in a huddle, as we said earlier.
But it doesn't matter. As the years go by, they'll never, ever stop. Every time a player's kicked 100 goals, they've never been able to stop the crowd running on, and they never will.
What's the feeling like, Mac? Is it
I think definitely the first time, Bruce, you get a big thrill out of it. And, Lockett is, but he'd be hoping the crowd would get off the ground. He'd want to get on with the game. But it's a big thrill for any player, I think. But he would know it's his teammates. The delivery of the ball to Lockett today and throughout the year has been magnificent. But he's such a great player himself. He's imposing. And I'll repeat myself again, he's the best kick for goal I've ever seen.
His preparation's terrific, Pete, as he goes back plenty of yards, holds the ball very comfortably, and his follow-through is very direct and pointed, so all those things, basics, but they're so important if you want to dispose of the ball like that.
But what a great advantage for a side now, for Sydney, to have a guy like that up there. You know, when you come out of the centre and kick it in his direction, he'll get it 9 times out of 10 and he'll convert.
It's a masterstroke when he put his pen to the contract, wasn't it? Come here for both him and the club and for the city and for the AFL.
And it suited his personality. He doesn't like the limelight. He comes up here and, well, I think they're starting to know him now.
Plug of power. Who picks up the momentum now, Ross? So suddenly Sydney are away again, 8-4 to 5-4.
And in fact, it might take some of the pressure off for someone like Brendan Gale, for instance. Now that's happened, get away with it and just get going, get the footy going. Because the momentum certainly was with Richmond before that goal. But it was an important one for Sydney just to settle.
Got it so quickly too, hasn't he? I mean, we've still got a bit of footy to play before half-time, and already he's got his 6 goals.
Yes, we were thinking final quarter. Wouldn't it be nice if he got his 100th in the final quarter? And here we are in the second quarter, he's got them.
Unlike other seasons, he's had slow starts, I feel, this year, Lockett. A lot of matches, he really hasn't got a heap of goals until late. Remember against North Melbourne?
And he's been very consistent.
Well, they're celebrating, aren't they? And great support here for their champion, full forward.
And I think the guys in the yellow jackets were more intent on protecting Lockett than worrying about the crowd.
Well, it's a sensible thing to do. Dipper down on the boundary line. Extraordinary scenes here, weren't they?
Sensational, Macca. But I actually went out to the middle of the ground just to hear what the Richmond boys were saying. Obviously, they want to stay focused, and they did all congratulate Lockett by just so well done. But the good news is no player got hurt, and we're about to start the game again.
Yeah, great celebration in a way. And as Ross said, it can get a bit out of hand, but, well, they've had their moment.
Oh, look, I'm certainly don't take it wrong, Bruce. I mean, it's not detracting for that. It's a great thing.